chapter 8, verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
The truth is what's going to set you free. Psalms 1. Psalms, the wages of sin is death. Read.
But the gift of God is eternal life.
The gift of God is eternal life. The Most High gave you the laws as a gift in order to live forever. Proverbs 2. Our people enjoy death. Our people refuse to choose the way of life. They like the path of darkness, and they refuse to use the light. Read. 2 and 1.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 2 and verse 1. My son, if thou will receive my words and hide my commandments with thee, so that thou incline thine ear unto the wisdom.
Hey, brother, let me ask you a question. What's your nationality?
Let's do it. This is IUYCAZ. Hey, this is IUYCAZ. Hey, keeping the faith in the King, and the patience will give us the strength.
That's a trick question.
That's not a trick question. That's what the problem with our people is. Because if I had, let's say, 10 people who look like us, and we asked them what their nationality, you know what kind of answers we get?
African-American,
that's one of the number ones now. Moors. Then we get blacks, we get Moors, we get Afro-Americans, we get colored, Asiatic black, all of this, oh yeah, we get religions like Baptist, Christian, Catholic. So, and brother, you look a little bit older than you were born before 1986, right?
Yeah.
Jesse Jackson is the one who coined the term African-American. If you look on your birth certificate, it won't say African-American. Yours will probably say Negro. Yes, because that's not a nationality. Our nationalities, if you look at the sign here, brother, mm-hmm. It says American black, right? Mm-hmm. What's next to it?
American Judah.
It says Judah, exactly, because the so-called black man in America is from the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
You are an Israelite according to the Bible.
You know?
That information has been hidden from you because they want you to believe that you are from two Caucasians. African American is two white men. Africa, that's Scipios Africanus. That's an Italian general who conquered Hannibal in the Second Punic Wars. That is a white man. America, that's Amerigo Vespucci. He was an Italian navigator who came over to this side of the land where other Israelites are already and named this land from Arsarith to America.
Right.
So when you say you're African American, you're saying you descend from two white men.
Bring it out.
Is that possible?
No.
Exactly. It's not possible. It's not technically in any way that you look at it, it's not possible. We're gonna bring out who you are, brother. So you would be a descendant from the slave trade, correct? So we're gonna bring out some information. Deuteronomy 28. What our people, and I'm so happy that you walked by and stopped here, brother. My name is Gamaliel. Your name is?
Jerry.
Nice to meet you, Jerry. All right, brother. We gonna bring out some information to teach you in the church. You're never gonna learn this in any church. Do you go to church?
Yeah, I'm a preacher.
Okay, well, we gonna bring out some information that they're not bringing out in the church. Usually in the church, they like to stay in the New Testament, right? Dip into the Old Testament a little bit, you know, maybe bring out some tithes and offers, right? Sure. Yeah, we gonna bring out something from the Old Testament, and we gonna see if it bears witness with what happened to our people. Deuteronomy 28:15.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So, you say you're a preacher, so I assume that you know about Moses and the Israelites, and I would assume that you know about what's going on here in Deuteronomy 28, right? So, Moses is telling the Israelites, if you don't keep God's laws, this is what's going to happen to you. Just verse 32 real quick.
Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thine eyes shall look and fail with them longing for them all the day long, and there shall be no might in thine hand.
So the Bible says God told Moses to tell the Israelites that if you don't keep my laws, your sons and your daughters are going to be given to another people, and your eyes are going to look and fail with longing for them all the day long, and there's going to be no mind in your hand to get your children back. Who did that happen to? That happened to us. Yes, sir. Now, is there any other group of people that can identify with that curse on the magnitude that it happened to us? Not at all. Let's go to 68, just to kind of nail in the coffin. We could go throughout all these curses, and we're going to find that it's our thumbnail, but 68 is the nail in the coffin. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Who came into slavery on ships? Read.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee.
Moses said, the same way I said it's going to happen, that's exactly how it's going to happen. Read.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
We won't see our homeland again. Have we seen our homeland ever since?
No.
No, sir. Read.
And there,
when you get off those slave ships,
ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
Who was sold unto their enemies? Read.
For bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy thee.
So when it says no man shall buy you, buying is a Quaker, is an old Quaker word. You use it to save or redeem. So we had Sojourner Truth, Marcus Garvey, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Nat Turner. All these saviors came up to try to get us out of the oppression that we were in. But we live like this still. So did it work? No, because no man is going to buy us. The only one that can save us is Jesus the Christ.
That's right.
So just based on the curses alone, the so-called black man in America is an Israelite. We could go further into the book and prove that we know that you're from the tribe of Judah, and that's based on the prophecies in Genesis 49. We could go there. However, all of that doesn't matter. You know you're an Israelite. What do you need to do? Well, let's go hit it. Deuteronomy 10 to 12. We're going, because that is part of it. That is part. Well, that's part. Because we, and also what I want to get, because there's certain things that our people say. We say things like, you got to have faith. You got to believe. You got to do this. You got to do that. We need to find out what those words mean. Read.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12.
Read.
And now Israel.
Now you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Read.
What doeth the Lord thy God require of thee?
What does God require of an Israelite? Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God.
To fear God. Read.
To walk in all his ways.
To walk in his ways. These are action words. Read.
And to love him.
Read.
And to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul.
Read.
To keep the commandments of the Lord and his statutes which I command thee this day for thy good.
So the Most High God says, the Israelites, we're supposed to be keeping God's commandments. One of God's commandments, so we're going to bring it out right now, brother. You see, every brother over here, and if you were to come to any of our congregations, everyone in the congregation, we all do this. Numbers 15, 38. Basically, all we're doing, bro, since you took the time to stop, talk to us, we want to show you love. Because you are a brother. Read.
The book of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 38. Speak unto the children of Israel, and bid them that they make fringes in the borders of their garments.
So the Most High God told Moses to tell us, to command us, rather, to put fringes on the borders of our garments. Read.
Throughout their generations.
When it says throughout your generations, what does that mean? Exactly. Forever. Until you stop generating, we're supposed to be wearing fringes on all our on the borders of all our garments. Read.
And that they put upon the fringe of the rib of the borders a ribbon of blue.
And there's supposed to be a blue ribbon on that border. As your brothers, we have to tell you these things because we love you and we want you to get the kingdom. Just like you said, you gotta have the faith that you gotta believe in Christ. Exactly. Well, you gotta believe in Christ. In order to believe in Christ, you have to walk just as Christ did. Christ walked perfect. Christ kept all the commandments of God.
That's right.
So in order to be like Christ, in order to believe in him, we must do the same. So I see that you can grow your beard. You're not gonna do it? Well, let's see what the Bible says, brother. Read. Leviticus. Because that's one of the things that goes on with our people. We look at the commandments of God and think that they're grievous unto us. The Most High God told us these commandments for a particular reason. Read.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 21 and verse 5. They shall not make baldness upon their head.
So we're not supposed to bald our heads like Tyrese or Michael Jordan. Read.
Neither shall they shave off the corners of their beard.
Every brother around here, we keep our beards because the Most High God told us to do that thing. So we're not supposed to shave that thing. But when you say you're not going to do it,
right,
you're saying that you're not going to keep God's laws.
Right.
So, read it. What is it?
Paul said Paul got a haircut.
Yes, he did. He didn't shave his head bald. Yes. That's okay to shave. We didn't say you can't cut your hair. Brothers got low cuts. That's
sure.
But they not bald.
Right.
No.
No, and I'm not getting on the bald head. I'm talking about the marring your beard. Your beard is marred, brother. Your beard. That's what I brought the scripture out for. That is not only a Greek fashion, that's an Egyptian fashion. What is that in Leviticus 18? 18 and 1? We're gonna read the reason why God told us not.
Did Paul cut off his beard?
No, he didn't cut off the beard.
He cut off his...
No, sir. He did not cut off his beard. He cut off his hair because Paul was keeping the law of a Nazarite at the time. So he ended his covenant as a Nazarite and cut off his hair, which was very, very long from growing it as a Nazarite. He ended keeping the ordinance of a Nazarite. He did not cut his beard off because that would have been breaking the law. There's no reason to cut your beard off in order to end your pledge as a Nazarite. You have to apply a razor to your hair, and that's what he did. Read
the book of Leviticus, chapter 18, verse 1. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel.
So God spoke unto Moses, told him to tell us, read.
And say unto them, I am the Lord your God. After the doings of the land of Egypt, wherein ye dwell, shall ye not do.
The Egyptians were the ones who shaved themselves from head to toe. They didn't want no hair on their bodies. The Most High God told us to keep our hair because he did not want us to do as the Egyptians.
That's right.
He wanted us to break away from those customs. Because the Lord put a difference between us and the Egyptians. And just like it says in Acts 21 with Paul, they mistook him for an Egyptian. Because we look similar to the Egyptians, the original ones. They mistook Paul as an Egyptian, but the Most High God put a difference between us. That's the reason why we have customs that are not like theirs. That's the reason why we don't shave our bodies bald.
Right.
We don't do it. Yes, which one? What do you want?
The one about shaving. I can't think of it right this second.
What is, 11? I think so.
He wants the one where he shaved.
Because I don't remember where it's at, but I know what you're talking. It's in Acts. It's in Acts, but bro, I ain't gonna remember. I don't.
Okay, cut his hair a little bit.
Yeah, and like I was saying, he cut his hair to fulfill the law of the Nazarite.
Take a look at it.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. So is he looking for it? You know where it's at? Okay. Well, yeah. When they get it for me.
Sure.
Yeah. So what? Do you want to see anything? You want to see anything else?
No.
Because okay. And while before we pull that, but while he's looking for that for me, Matthew 5. Matthew 5, verse 17. Read.
The book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17. Think not that I've come to destroy the law or the prophets.
So Christ said, think not that I have come to destroy the law nor the prophets. Read.
I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
So when Christ said he came to fulfill, what does that mean? So Christ fulfilled the law. So if Christ fulfilled the law, that means that it's okay for us to go out and kill and steal and eat whatever we want, right? So what does that mean? Which law did Christ fulfill?
All of them.
So that's what I'm saying. If something is fulfilled, that means it's done to completion, right?
Right.
So So why? So that means that we don't have to keep them no more. Because there's one particular law that we actually don't have to keep right now. And that's what Christ is talking about. No, it's not what I'm thinking. It's what the Bible is going to say. However, the Bible tells us that the law that Christ fulfilled, bring it out, is a law of sacrifice. That's the reason why we don't sacrifice no goats and lambs no more. That's the only law that Christ fulfilled. Everything else is still in effect.
That's right.
Read that for me in Luke. 24. Bring that up.
The book of Luke, chapter 24, verse 44.
Read.
And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you.
And we're going to get the words that Christ spoke while he was yet with us. Read.
All things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses, and in the prophets, and in the Psalms concerning me.
Everything that was written in the prophets and the Psalms concerning Christ is what he fulfilled. So what you would have to do is find a scripture in the Old Testament that said Christ was going to do away with the law. Because there are scriptures that say that Christ is going to do away with sacrifice. You can find that in Psalms. But you're not going to find one that says he's going to do away with the law.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.